On a Tuesday night first, I asked this to Bridgie after full time. What's it like to be part of a performance like that?
Hi, lads. How are you? Hey, 32 today, lads. You wouldn't have thought it, would you? Thank you very much. Thank you very much. What was that again?
What's that question? Yeah, I said this to Bridgie after the game, that what was it like to be part of a performance like that? Because it was near perfect.
Yeah, it was a good night. Yeah, it was a nice night, especially after the disappointment of Saturday. Obviously coming then off the back of a good start against Crawley, so it was a nice pick me up, if you like, to go there and do that to any championship side, whether they made changes or not, is some going like 3-0, and it realistically, although obviously the possession stats say different, we could have had a few more, so it's not as like just saying to the lads in there, weren't like a 3-0 snatch and grab, we could have had a couple more, so I think it was a well-earned victory, yeah.
I was in the dressing room briefly after the Swindon game. You were one of the guys talking about the fact that we can't allow what happened at Swindon to happen. How good was it to get the response on Tuesday?
Yeah, it was, yeah. Because, yeah, sadly, it was disappointment. It was more disappointing just because the position we put ourselves in, like, what was it like after an hour in the game and 1-0 up away from home? First half was tough, but you go to a good team like that and you know you're going to have to ride the storm a little bit, and we did. So you think, we've done the hard work, we then, with the wind, get the lead, and then to do what we did, it was criminal, yeah, it was criminal, but hopefully it was the second game of the season. We spoke after the game, we're still learning, so it's a new team. Hopefully that shouldn't happen again.
People use buzzwords like character and spirit, but we've shown it, haven't we? Because to come back 48 hours after Saturday, it was a great, excellent way for the team to respond.
Not half, yeah, definitely. You just don't want that to be up and down, you know. We've got to find that level of consistency. Hey, can you just put that camera onto him? He's got some bad gear on today. So much money, but his gear is horrendous. So much money. Oh, he's staying here now to listen, isn't he? Come on, I don't mind. What?
We're talking about spirit and character.
Spirit and character. You got superstars like Nathan, you know what I mean? Just win you the game. Just give him the ball, he wins you the game, doesn't he? Simple as that. No, yeah, it was good to come back, yeah. And then, obviously, to go there and do that to them was nice, yeah.
You just mentioned the fact that we don't want it to be up and down. That's key, isn't it? We want some consistency.
Of course, yeah, but it's early days, you know what I mean? We've only had 3 games, and realistically, you know, the Swindon was half an hour of just real disappointment. But apart from that, it looks like we've been bang at it, and things are looking good, yeah, so fingers crossed.
Everybody spoke about the hard work put in through the summer. Jonah, does it feel like it's all coming to fruition?
Yeah, it does actually, yeah. And obviously there's a lot of faces, this new face this season, but it doesn't feel like that, you know what I mean? It feels like already, like we've been together a long time, some good lads in there, everyone's gone on well already, and there's some good characters in there, some big characters, and yeah. It's exciting. It really is exciting. And you look at Tuesday and you think what we can do to a team like that. And if we can take that into a league now, teams are going to fear us, hopefully, yeah.
You don't change, Jonah. You approach this profession in a certain way. But if you don't mind me saying, it feels like a real edge to you this season.
Well, it's fourth season here now. And you know what I set out to do when I first come to the club, and it still hasn't been done. So I think every year gets a little bit more, maybe kind of anger as well, like a little bit of frustration and willingness to finally achieve what I want to do at this football club, and obviously that's promotion. So yeah, you could say that. I just want to get promoted, and I'm excited now, and the gaffer looks like he's got a great set of lads together, and hopefully we can go on a journey together now and get the job done.
And the style of football seems to suit what you do.
Yeah, of course, yeah. Gaffer wants to play. He's made no secret of that. And obviously, there's no one who loves getting on the ball more than me. So, but the other side of that, he asks for high-intensity football. He expects us to, you know, grafting out there. And, you know, that kind of comes naturally to me. I always feel like I give everything anyway. So it's good, yeah. I really enjoy playing for him. And obviously, it was a big part of me coming back here, yeah.
Mansfield on Saturday, we all know that home form can be key to any team's success.
Yeah, so obviously beating Crawley, and then, yeah, it'd be a tough game because they're one of the teams that'll be up there. So strong team, got good strikers. But yeah, here, we need to win the majority of games, and you get what you can on the road, don't you? That's as simple as that. That's how you get promoted. So we'll be looking to take it on, and coming from the back of Tuesday, I don't think they'll be too excited about coming here. So look, start the game well, and see what we can do to them. Yeah,
great celebrations with the fans at the end of the game on Tuesday. It'd be lovely to do it here on Saturday with the home lot.
Yeah, it was. It was great following as well. You know, what was it, 385 or something? You know, different class. Like on a Tuesday night away there. So you know what I'm like. I always speak highly of the fans, and hopefully we can give them another 3 points and send them home happy on another Saturday afternoon. Yeah,
thanks for your time again, John.